Welcome everyone, I'm Laura Hsu, author of the Lightroom blog and Lightroom workshops on video at laurahsu.com. Recently I read an article about how to add catch lights to eyes using Photoshop, so I thought I'd show you how to do the same thing here in Lightroom. I'm going to zoom in on my eye and I'm going to paint in a catch light with the adjustment brush. Now anytime I come into the adjustment brush, I like to reset all of the sliders so that I don't accidentally paint with something I don't mean to. So I'll do so by double-clicking on the word effect. I want to paint with positive exposure. And nothing is happening in the photo because I haven't yet said where. I want to use a fairly small brush. You can change the size of your brush using the size slider down here, or you can use the left and right bracket keys on your keyboard. I also want my brush to have a soft edge rather than a harsh one. So I've set the feather slider here to 100. I'm simply going to click in my eye and let go to paint the catch light. Now this pin that's a record of my changes is in the way of me evaluating the catch light. So as I move my mouse out of the photo, the pin is hidden. And that's the case because I have show edit pins here set to auto hide. Now at this point the catch light has a reddish cast to it. Because adding four stops to exposure wasn't enough to blow out that area or turn it pure white, we're seeing some of the underlying residual color. So in addition to painting with positive exposure, I'm going to paint with negative saturation. I'll go ahead and take it to negative 100. Now at this point, if I feel like I've added too much exposure, I can simply adjust the amount. It's hard for me to tell when I'm zoomed in so far, so I'm going to click on fill to zoom out. And I think it's looking pretty good. I'm going to zoom back in to show you that if you need to add more light, if +4 on exposure is not enough, if you have a dark eye like this one, you can also use the shadow slider. So as we add light into the shadows where we've painted, you can see how bright I can get that catch light in my eye. Way too bright, of course. Another option, for example, if you're working with a light colored eye and shadows doesn't work, is to add another adjustment right on top of this one. If you have Lightroom 4 or earlier, you'll click on New and you'll paint that area again. If you have Lightroom 5, you can duplicate this adjustment by right-clicking or control-clicking on the pin and choosing Duplicate. Now there's a second instruction sitting on top of the first one, and as I move my mouse out, you can see the cumulative effect of the two adjustments. I can then dial back the top adjustment to get just the amount that I'm looking for. Next, I would hold the space bar down so that I can click and drag over to my other eye. Now the eyes are of different brightnesses starting out, so I very well might want different settings for the catch light in this eye. So I'm going to do a brand new adjustment, and I'll start again with positive exposure and negative saturation, and I'll click. Move my mouse out. That's not enough, so I'll add light into the shadows, maybe zoom out so I can get some perspective here, and then I continue to work on it from here. I think they're too bright at this point. Now, this pin is active, it's black, so I can simply dial back the exposure some. To get back to this catch light or this pin, I need to click on it to make it active, and then I can adjust from here. Okay, so that's how to add catch lights using Lightroom. If you've enjoyed this video, do check out my blog at laurahsu.com and sign up for newsletter updates to hear about new tutorials and videos. Finally, if you're watching from YouTube, subscribe to my YouTube channel. I'm Laura Hsu.